Good morning, everyone. Sorry to hold you up. We're going to make an announcement with regard to the notice that was sent out on cycling here in Philadelphia. But I thought it most appropriate, given that yesterday was Election Day and we've had a pretty significant change in leadership at the state level, that I would certainly address those particular issues first. So first and foremost, I had the opportunity last night to talk with now Governor-elect Tom Wolf and congratulated him. I'd seen him earlier in the day, but waited, of course, until after a number of media outlets and others had made the declaration that Tom Wolf, in fact, did win sizably yesterday. First, I want to congratulate him. Certainly want to acknowledge and express appreciation in the most appropriate way to Governor Tom Corbett. Thank him for his service, not only as governor, but his previous public service. Elections are about decisions. The voters have spoken, and obviously we need to move forward. It's clear that in so many, many ways, yesterday's election was in fact a referendum on the issue of education in not only Philadelphia, but across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And I think voters fully understood the impact of the severity of cuts that have been made across the Commonwealth. Various school districts having to raise taxes, and certainly here in Philadelphia, I have worked very closely with our own Philadelphia City Council to raise significant revenues over the past 5 years, $357 million of new recurring revenues to our school district, which in a five-year period is the largest amount of new dollars coming into the district in 30 years. We need a student-weighted funding formula to better educate our children all across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and certainly here in Philadelphia. So I look forward to working with Governor-elect Wolf and his team. We've already had some conversations about some of the things that we want to try to do here in Philadelphia. Lori Schur, our Chief Education Officer, she and her team stand fully prepared to work with Governor-elect Wolf and his team through the transition and certainly going forward. I would also expect that we should see a change in the relationship between and among the city, the Commonwealth, and the School Reform Commission, the SRC. It is certainly my goal to make sure that Governor-elect Wolf and soon to be Governor Wolf and I will have a much closer working relationship in trying to support and better direct the efforts and responsibilities of the School Reform Commission. And with that in mind, it is certainly my strong recommendation that notwithstanding whatever the lawyers may be doing for the district or the SRC or the PFT, that the most direct path to getting a resolution to the outstanding contract issues between the district and the PFT is for all parties to immediately get back to a true bargaining table to hammer through and work out the issues that are subjects of that collective bargaining process, but also to keep in mind the number one individuals in any of these disputes are our students. They need help, they need support, they need resources, and certainly need their teachers and counselors and nurses and other support personnel in a classroom, in a building, getting work done and supporting their efforts to get a great education. So it's time to get back to the bargaining table, and it's time for us to move this city and this state forward in terms of education, which clearly was the number one issue on many, many voters' minds yesterday, among a number of other things. So with that, I'd be glad to take any questions on this issue. And after that, I want to move into the main issue of this particular press conference. Steve. Sure. The governor-elect and I have talked about that particular issue. I think he even more clearly understands, based on the conversations that we've had and the things that he said to me, that funding really has to be first. You could put Thomas Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln, and Martin Luther King on the School Reform Commission, and we would still have a financial problem. And so governance is significant, it is important, but the most important challenge is getting funding to our district. And unfortunately, again, our school district and 499 other districts at varying levels suffered as a result of about $1 billion in cuts over the past few years. And so we need to stay focused on the main issue at hand, which is funding. And I'm more than ready at a subsequent time to get into issues of governance and, you know, who's appointed or how they get there or all of those details. But no matter who's there, if you don't have any money, you can't run the place and provide our students the high quality education that they deserve. Well, at present, we don't have one, so there's really nothing to tinker with. You'd have to create one in the first instance. And I mean, we have not, as you can imagine, he's running for governor or has been for some time. So we have not gotten anywhere near the details of what a student-weighted funding formula would look like. There is a commission that's operating. What I can tell you, though, is that there are at least 47 other examples in the United States, as we are only one of three states in the country that doesn't use a student-weighted funding formula. So I don't think you have to look too far to find some examples, find some models, and then take, if you want, bits and pieces from some of those models and craft something that works for Pennsylvania and the 500 school districts across the Commonwealth. Any other questions on yesterday? We're all good? Great. Okay. So I'm joined today by a number of advocates and I would suggest experts and athletes in cycling from across the city and around the region. I want to give thanks and recognition, certainly first and foremost, to our Deputy Mayor for Transportation and Utilities, Rhina Cutler. She could not be with us for this particular announcement, but her Chief of Staff, Andrew Stober, is here, and I want to thank him. Alex Doty, who you're going to hear from shortly, from the Bicycle Coalition. You will take note that my wife is here in a different capacity today, but she is the president of Philadelphia Academies, but also an avid cyclist. Bicycling is a fundamental aspect of a city's mobility, economic development, public health, and environmental sustainability. Bicycling is an important mode of transportation for a variety of reasons. Commuters and students seeking a quick, inexpensive way to get where they're going can do so. Seniors seeking to stay active while doing errands or their other daily activities. And low-income residents who may not own cars or anyone who does not live very close to our extensive public transportation network. Of the top 10 big cities in America, Philadelphia has the highest percentage of bicycle commuters per capita. More than 13,000 Philadelphians cycle to work on a regular basis. Being a bike-friendly city is also important in attracting tourists and new residents, incorporating physical exercise into daily activities and helping residents get to know that their neighborhood, they can be an eyes on the street in their neighborhood, also helping to make them safer. Our administration has been involved from day one and has led our efforts to make our city a more bike-friendly Philadelphia. Through the great work of our City Planning Commission, which has produced the Philadelphia 2035 Master Plan and the Pedestrian and Bicycle Plan, the city now has more than 500 miles of bike lanes. Earlier this year in April, we announced that the city had selected a team to plan, install, and operate Philadelphia's very first new bike share system, bicycle transit systems. B-Cycle will provide the equipment, the stations, and the technology platform for this system. We are eagerly anticipating the launch of this system in the spring of 2015. Our system also will be the first of its kind in the nation to not require a credit card. And for that, we want to thank our foundation community for supporting our efforts at a more equitable bike share system. This past July, you may recall that Lisa and I led a delegation of business people and cycling leaders on a trip to France to promote, among other things, cycling in Philadelphia. We toured the Paris bike sharing system, the LEAP. I still carry my card today, never know when I might need it. And we met with the president of the Union Cycliste Internationale, UCI, which is the governing body for cycling around the world, to discuss the possibility of Philadelphia participating in a Women's World Cup cycling event in 2015. I'm proud to announce today for the first time that Philadelphia will in fact host a Women's World Cup Series event, which is currently being rebranded as the Women's Professional Road Cycling Series. This was a decision made by UCI as a result of a series of presentations that we made in July. We went there to try to get a Women's World Cup in Philadelphia. We won. The Parks Casino Philadelphia Cycling Classic will join an elite list of cycling events in the series, becoming the first one to be added in the United States of America. The Parks Casino Philly Cycling Classic is notably one of the few races that offers equal purse prizes to the women's and men's race winners, an idea that was actually proposed by Lisa. This fact is clearly setting a positive trend for other races to adopt as women's professional cycling continues to grow. And we plan to promote it right here in Philadelphia. We like the men's cyclists as well. It's for all these reasons and more that I'm here also today to announce that I'm creating the Philadelphia Bicycle Advocacy Board by executive order. The city of Philadelphia is poised to emerge as one of the nation's great cycling cities, and we want to increase the ways in which we are already encouraging bicycling. When we met with the UCI, they were very clear back in July that they want to expand professional cycling in the United States of America and look at Philadelphia, a 30-year history of cycling, and a great race that's recognized around the world that many national and international cyclists participate in. But they recognize our commitment, our effort, across a variety of steps that we've taken over the years, and decided that they wanted to have the Women's World Cup Series come to Philadelphia. The Philadelphia Bicycling Advocacy Board, or because everything we do in government runs by acronym, soon to be known as the PBAB, will advise the mayor on ways to promote bicycling among Philadelphians and on public policies that affect cyclists, foster volunteer efforts that promote cycling and maintain cycling trails, encourage private sector support of cycling, especially among Philadelphia employers for their employees who want to or already commute to work by bicycle, and finally, promote national and international races in Philadelphia to attract the most elite cyclists to compete in our city. The PBAB will also serve as a liaison to promote cycling to the business community, schools, civic associations, and other groups. The members of the board that I'm appointing today, not all of whom were able to make it, but many, are Phil Seneschal, who is the Velodrome planning team leader, Joe Wenzel, co-owner, Breakaway Bikes, Pat Kinane, President, Advanced Sports International, Lisa Nutter, President, Philadelphia Academies Incorporated, Ms. Camille DeRocher, Technical Consultant, Ms. Kristen Gavin, who's Executive Director of Gearing Up, a great organization in our city, Sean Petty, USA Cycling and Union Cyclists International, Mr. Marty Nostein, President, Valley Preferred Cycling Center, who is also an Olympic gold medal track cyclist, Ms. Heidi Grumwald, co-creator of the Pump Track, which is out on Parkside Avenue in the Parkside section of Philadelphia. Mr. Alex Doty, executive director of the Bicycle Coalition in Philadelphia. Ryan Okers, founder of the Cadence Foundation. Mr. Matt Diefenbach, senior account manager at Motorola. Mr. Gary Ryan, owner of V13. And Mr. Mark Featherman, who is an attorney. As a chair of the board, I'm also appointing Karen Bliss. Let me tell you about Karen Bliss. Karen has a master's degree in sports marketing from the University of Florida and a bachelor's degree in social work from Penn State University. She is a seven-time national champion on the road and track, is serving a three-year term on the USA Cycling's Road Committee, and was a member of the business delegation that went to Paris last year. Karen will be the chair of this committee, of this board. Cycling is not just about being on a bicycle for exercise or transportation. It's also about youth development, sustainability, healthy living, and the economic impact on the sport on Philadelphia, of the sport on Philadelphia. The Philadelphia Bicycling Advocacy Board will bring us closer to being the greatest cycling city in the United States of America. With that, I'm going to sign the executive order and then ask Alex from the Bicycle Coalition to come up and say a few words. This is Executive Order Number 10-14, the Philadelphia Bicycling Advocacy Board. It is so ordered and created. We're now going to have Alex Doty, Bicycle Coalition Executive Director, to come up and speak, and after that, we'd be pleased to take any questions. Alex?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think I'm the person in this group that would get dropped on a ride. This is a very impressive group of people who are familiar with bicycling in Philadelphia and are serious about the sport and the culture of bicycling. I think what this group is really well positioned to do is to talk about the culture of bicycling in Philadelphia. We have done a lot and have a lot more to do about making bicycling an inviting and popular thing for people to do where they feel safe and comfortable riding a bike anywhere where they want to go in the city of Philadelphia. But if there's nothing else that the city of Portland has taught us, it is that culture matters a lot in getting people to bike. And we have a great anchor for that kind of activity in the race in the city of Philadelphia, the Parks Philadelphia Cycling Classic, and that the effort to make that race be a leader in the world for women's cycling, to have an equal purse, follows on much of what we want to do in the city of Philadelphia to make bicycling more attractive to women. We know that about a third of the bicyclists in Philadelphia are women, and we know that if we get to half, that we will have more bicyclists than any other city in the United States. Having this kind of an advisory board, a board that is made up of people who are here to think about bicycling in Philadelphia for the long haul. This is a board that is being created by the mayor who has done the most to make the city of Philadelphia bike friendly, but is something that has the legs to continue to do that work beyond this administration for the many things that we need to do to build Philadelphia into a great bicycling city. And I'm here to say that Philadelphia has more of an opportunity to be a great bicycling city than I think any other large city in the United States. A lot of that has to do with the way that our city is built, but a lot of that has to do with the people who are behind me. And when we think about what Kristen Gavin has done around the bike and saying that this, we're going to use the bike as a tool for helping women who are coming out of jail and coming out of addiction recovery programs. When we think about what Ryan has done to try and say we want, started by saying, I want to find the next Olympian for the United States in West Philadelphia or North Philadelphia, came to the realization that we don't just need Olympians, we need our students to graduate from high school, and turned that program into something that was about saying, we want to make our city better. The bike is a tool, but it's about, at the heart of it, it's about making Philadelphia a better place to live and to be. And then just to think about what the possibilities are if we brought a velodrome to Philadelphia and the kind of programming that we could have to go along with that. All of this about building up the culture of biking to go along with the many improvements that we've made and continue to make, and the Bicycle Coalition is certainly a big part of advocating for, to try and make our streets safer for bicyclists. And my little pitch and advocacy there is that in making our streets safer for bicyclists, we're making them safer for everybody. I think it's remarkable what's happened on Spruce and Pine streets. All of us will go out of our way to go for a ride down Spruce and Pine instead of another street. But the other thing that's remarkable about Spruce and Pine is that motor vehicle crashes have gone down on Spruce and Pine Street by almost a third in the time since we've built that street, with no reduction in the travel time to go across those streets. So that was my, I had to do my job at the end of that to just talk about streets for a minute. But I'm really looking forward to the work of this committee and proud to be on it.
Alex, thank you. Thank you very, very much. So with that, we'd be glad to try to answer any questions that you might have with regard to the Philadelphia Bicycling Advocacy Board. Any questions on that? All right. We must have done a great job. Thank you all very, very much, and see you out on a bike soon. Bye-bye.